I think the concept of getting a deal done is the most important thing. Look at how the markets and certain asset prices have adjusted. So you've had a 2% dollar rally in the last 3 weeks, pretty quiet, right? And you've had a chance to see yields test that 1% level on the 10-year and bounce, and I think are moving a bit higher. You've had commodity prices and some of the, at least, the byproducts of where you could see infrastructure spend as part of fiscal really actually trade phenomenally well, especially in the face of a stronger dollar. Look at Brent and crude, you know, near essentially almost 1 year highs. You have a move in copper, which has been very supportive. So look, I think markets expect to see some deal here. That's not the question. The size of the deal certainly could, I think, influence overall, but either way, we're moving that way. And I would be fading this dollar move, and therefore, I think you can be buying commodities, you can be buying these resource trades, you can be buying the banks, because I think they're all going to benefit.
Signal that they might be open to some negotiation. Senator Collins had mentioned that they might be willing to go higher in their direct checked amount of $1,000 to come closer to the $1,400 that President Biden had promised, if he would be interested in lowering the threshold for eligibility. So those are some of the discussions that are going to be underway during this meeting. But it is clear that Democrats, Brian, are also making the case that they don't want to wait around for Republicans to get on board here. That is why they took the first step of passing or of at least introducing a budget resolution in both the House and the Senate so they can move forward without Republican support. We will see and hear from these senators after the meeting is over, so we'll find out exactly how it went.